I'm just feeling very excited. I feel very blessed. You know, there was a nervousness beforehand, but as soon as we start to walk up that aisle to begin Mass, kind of just, God was there, God was present, and I was in the moment. So I really appreciated to celebrate with everyone there in prayer. To lay down on the floor at the Litany of the Saints, you just kind of feel the weight of everyone's prayers. Everyone's singing, pray for us. You know, we're going through all these saints, and saints that Tom and I picked, saints that we have devotion to, saints that have walked with us along this journey, who have been great intercessors for us. And so to hear everyone to pray to the intercession of those, it's a profound moment. Really just the primary role of service to the people of God, especially to those who are poor and vulnerable, that's what we're here for. We're here to bring Christ to them, to walk with them, to accompany them, to journey with them, and to give God's blessing to them. The support, the prayers, the friendship, the love that's there, there's no words for it. I'm just so grateful for them. And the next step on my journey towards priesthood, but even ordination to the diaconate, or one day ordination to the priesthood, that's not the end of the journey. There's more steps that come with it, more challenges, more areas for growth, and a lot more blessings that are here. And I feel those blessings right now. I know there's some big challenges ahead of me to open the scriptures, to preach to the people, to minister, to serve them. But I know God is present every step of the way.
For you see, for all of the formation that they have and will continue to receive as they prepare for diaconal ministry and eventually priestly service, at the heart of the sacrament of holy orders is a ministry that fundamentally looks outside of the ones to whom it is given. Tom and Andrew, quite simply, you are not being ordained today for your own well-being. The very nature of the sacrament of holy orders, when authentically embraced, demands that you and all of us as deacons, priests, and bishops focus on those whom we have been called to serve.
I really feel like I'm the happiest guy in the world right now. Honestly, maybe it's between me and Andrew McCarroll. It was just incredibly humbling to see so much support from friends and family. And then to finally have the day arrive from so many years of study and formation, it's beyond words. It's incredible. As Bishop Embarrass said, that's what it means to gather. That's what it means to be the people of God assembled. We're not, no one's on this journey alone. It's in a community. I've discerned in a community. Just reiterating a very strong call to serve. You know, that's very big for him, as it is for so many of the priests in this diocese and the deacons as well. And just that really struck to me, that this is not about my sanctification, it's about the glorification of God and the sanctification of his people. I could talk about it for days on end, but particularly having my good friend Michael, Deacon Michael, vest me with the stole and the dalmatic. He was tearing up, I was tearing up, and by the grace of God, I kept it together somewhat. That was very powerful. I'm enjoying today right now, and it's sort of struggling to get beyond that right now, what happened, you know, just a few minutes ago. But yes, ultimately, to think that priesthood is a year away, you know, I just can't reiterate enough. Thank you so much to all the people who have been praying for me. I'm overwhelmed by the support. I wouldn't be here without them.
Mercifully hear our prayer.